So good afternoon, and this is the third law, that is Kepler's third law, that is law of periods. So see, what is the statement? The square of the time period of revolution of a planet is proportional to the cube of the semi major axis of the ellipse traced out by the planet. Means what? T square is directly proportional to a cube, hai na? Or he is saying the average distance between the sun and the planet, that is nothing but what? T square is directly proportional to average distance between sun and planet and its cube, hai na? Or like this two statements are there. Now
y square of time period, sir.
So see why what we can say, why average distance and a cube, they have mentioned it differently, are they same? Okay, right? So see here, now what I am doing, I am taking first one ellipse, right? See here, this is the ellipse. And let us assume that here is sun. Here is sun. Okay. And now this is the planet which is revolving around the sun. Wait. Right? Now we know this distance is this distance and this distance. Okay. What is this distance called? RP. What is this distance called? RA. Hai na? Okay.
Yes,
this planet is revolving around the sun. Its time period is T. Time period T means what? The time taken by planet to complete one revolution. Okay. And y square and y cube, that is what your question, someone asked you, asked me, right? So when we are observing, its proof is also there. Y square and cube is there. This is observation things as well as proof is also there, which we are going to learn ahead. Y t square and a cube. Okay. For the time being, just try to understand this law. Immediately after this law, we will learn y t square and y a cube. Okay. So see, now this is time period, that is T. And what is time period? The time taken to complete one revolution around the sun. Okay. Now, see here. But why I wrote average distance and semi-major axis cube? Are these two same? Yes. So I am writing here one question. Average distance, or what is the relation? I am writing like this. What is the relation? What is the relation between average distance and semi-major axis? So let's see. Semi-major axis is A, and average distance is what? R average is equal to average distance between sun and planet. How we will find out? We will find out like this: RP plus RA by 2. Ekne? RP plus RA by 2. Like this, we will find out average distance. Now, RP value, we know. What is RP value? Yes. What is RP value? A into, bolo, A into 1 minus E.
Minus E.
Plus RA is what? A into 1 plus E divided by 2. So here, this is what? A minus AE plus A plus AE divided by 2. Now this plus AE and this minus AE cancel. What we will get here? 2A by 2. Okay, nahi? 2A by 2. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. And what is the relation which we got? R average is similar to the semi-major axis. That is what R average is equal to A.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, how time period will be directly proportional to the R average, sir?
Very good. See, for that we are having one derivation. Okay. Centripetal force and gravitational force, when we are equating, what is the case there? That derivation we will see ahead. See, if suppose I will tell just briefly, try to understand. This is suppose sun. Okay. And here this is a planet which is revolving around it. Okay. Try to understand. Now this is planet and this is sun, right? Now it is having one centripetal force and gravitational force which is going to balance, right or wrong, means in equilibrium. So this planet is having mass m, velocity v and orbital radius r. So here centripetal force mv square by r is equal to gravitational force between these two, gmm by r square. So from this, if m and this r will get cancelled, you are getting v square is equal to gm by r. Okay. Now, speed is there, right? Velocity. Velocity is equal to what, or speed is equal to what? Total perimeter 2 pi r divided by time period. Yes? Yes or no? Getting clarity. So at the place of this v square, if I will substitute that, at the place of this v square, what I am getting? 2 pi r divided by t whole square is equal to gm by r, and therefore 4 pi r square divided by t square is equal to gm by r. Now this r you transfer here and this t square here, this gm this side. So 4 pi r cube is equal to what you are getting? Gm and one more r this side. So I am writing this r also.
Sir, r cube, no sir.
That's why I am writing r, wait. So this r square into r is equal to gm t square. And now this 4 pi r cube divided by this gm is equal to t square. Now this 4 pi and this gm is constant. What you are getting? T square is proportional to r cube. Like this, you are getting this t square and r cube. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this derivation I will explain again. Just wait, because we should finish these two parts. That is Newton's law of gravitation and this centripetal force also. Then we will again come back to this law. Why you are getting this t square and r cube? Understood? Till now, any doubt?
No, sir.
So this part you don't write. Just try to understand now. I will give in notes later this in detail after Newton's law of gravitation. Okay?
Yes.
Understood? Yes, sir.
Clear, eh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So R average is nothing but what? R average is nothing but your semi-major axis. And the relation how you got that also we have learned just briefly. Yes, that is why T squared is proportional to R average cube. Now, see here. If suppose we are having two planets, then T1 by T2 whole square is equal to R1 by R2 you can say, or A1 by A2 you can say. Choice is yours, है ना? So I am writing A1 by A2. Yes. But I am writing A1 by A2. That is what semi-major axis whole cube. So yeah, now understood?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
हाँ, right? Clear?
Yes, sir.
हाँ.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here? Any doubt?
No, sir.
This whatever I explain now, this gravitational force and centripetal force. Immediately after this law, I will give that in the notes. So don't worry. Just write down this. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yes, this is first slide only. Yes. Clear है?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now presently what we have learned, T1 by T2 whole square is equal to A1 by A2 whole cube, and that is T square is diagonal proportional to A cube, or T square is diagonal proportional to R average whole cube. Right. Now let's solve some problems on this. So see here how they are asking problems. Very easy problems. I will solve first. Just try to understand. Then next you have to solve. Okay. So see. Problem. A Saturn year, is 29.5 times the Earth year, How far is the Saturn? From the sun? If the Earth is 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 kilometer away from the sun. Okay. Now, what is given here? First, shall I solve? Next, will you solve?
Yes, sir.
Now, see, Saturn year is given. Saturn year is given means, see, what they have given, time period they have given. So, time period of Saturn is equal to 29.5 times time period of Earth, we can say. Okay. Now, how far is the Saturn from the sun? it means average distance he is asking. So RS we don't know, hai na? RS we don't know. And RE is how much re? RE is how much? Do we know RE? How much is RE? They have given no. How much this is? 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 kilometer. And what is TE? TE kya hai? Let's keep TE as a TE only. Hai na? TE is equal to TE because this is in terms of TE. Is that clear? Yes. Yes. Okay. So now what is the relation between TE and R? We have one formula. TS by TE whole square is equal to RS by RE.
RS by RE whole square.
Whole? Cube R square R.
Cube, sir.
Right. Now, TS, I am substituting 29.5 times TE, hai na? TS at the place of TS, 29.5 TE divided by, this is TE only, whole square is equal to RS. Do we know RS? We don't know. So, RS as it is. And RE is what here? 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 and this whole bracket cube. Is that clear? Now yes, I am canceling this T and this T I am canceling. And here it is square of this. So I am getting 29.5 into 29.5. And this is cube now. So I am writing here 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 whole cube is equal to RS cube. Sahi na? Check karo. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now this is cube. So I am taking cube root of this all. So taking cube root, what I am getting? Cube root of this 29.5 into 29.5. And its cube root is what? 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 direct. This is equal to RS. Understand this part? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now 29.5 into 29.5 crore kitna hota hai? 870.25, hai na? So this is 870.25 and its cube root into 1.5 into 10 to the power 8, which is equal to RS. Now let's find out cube root of this. What we are getting, tell me. This is 9.54, hai na? Yes, nearly 9.5 hai na? 9.5 into 9.5 into 9.5 dekho. Hai ki nahi? 9.54 nearly. So I am taking 9.54 into this 1.5 into 10 to the power 8. Check karo, sahi hai kya? Yes. And this is you are getting 14.31 into 10 to the power 8 is equal to RS. And this is 14.31. So can I write like this? 1.431 into 10 to the power 9 kilometer. Say na. Yes or no? Check karo. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall I go to the next page?
1 minute, sir.
Yes. Yes, finished.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go to the next page. Now, one more problem. You have to solve this. Okay. You will do this as a homework. Okay, I will give just hint. Just you try to solve. Very easy question. The mean distance of mass from the sun, Mars, okay? The mean distance. The mean distance of the Mars. Of Mars from the sun. From the sun is 1.524 times that of Earth. That of Earth from the sun. From the sun. Find the number of years. Find the number of years. Find the number of years required for Mars. Required for Mars. To make one revolution about the sun. To make one revolution. To make one revolution about the sun. Can you do this? Can you do this?
Yes, sir.
See here, I am giving hint to you. You can do it. Given kya kya hai dekho yahan pe. Distance of Mars they have given, hai na? So shall I write like this? R of M is equal to 1.524 times R of E. And find the number of years required for Mars. So T of M is equal to how much? RE is RE only. And TE, you know, TE kitna rehta hai? Time period of Earth kitna hai? 1 year, hai ki nahi? आपको मालूम है ना ये. Now you have to use this TM by TE whole square is equal to RM by RE whole cube. Just substitute the values and do it yourself. This is your homework. Okay, shall I go to the next page? And its answer.
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Its answer is 1.88 years. You can send me the solution on our group. You can send me the solution. Okay?
Okay, sir.
All right. Let me go to the next page. Finished? Everyone finished?
Yes, sir.
I want to tell that because you will write in the notes that part also. Why that T square is directly proportional to R cube. So see here. Note point, you can write like this. You just write note point. And now, let us suppose this is a sun. And here is the planet which is revolving. Okay, which is revolving in an elliptical orbit or circular orbit, jo bhi hai. If elliptical orbit is there, we will take average distance. If circular orbit is there, we will take R. But I am drawing little bit elliptical, but you just try to understand, here is not the radius, I am taking average distance. Okay, so that's why I am taking here this as a capital R, that is R average between the sun and planet. Clear? Any doubt? Planet and this is sun. Now, as it is revolving, this planet is revolving with velocity, let us suppose V, around the sun, and let its mass be capital M, and this planet mass is small m. You know, gravitational force is equal to centripetal force, and that's why it is rotating. Gravitational force is equal to centripetal force. And gravitational force is equal to centripetal force. Gravitational force, you know, gmm divided by r square. Yes or no? Gmm by r square. Clear? आपको पता है, लोअर क्लासेस में पढ़ा है और एक बार हम आगे भी पढ़ेंगे. gmm by r square means this mass divided by r square. Any doubt? m v square by capital R. सही है ना? Clear? Now this
yes,
m, this m cancel, yes. This r cancel. So you got v square is equal to gm by capital R. Okay. And this R is not radius. I am telling what? This is the average distance of that elliptical orbit. So here, now, we know speed or velocity, whatever. Speed is equal to what rate? Total distance by time. Ye to hai na malum. Total distance divided by time. So what I am doing here, total distance by time. So for one revolution, how much distance it will cover? 2 pi r divided by time period is t. So therefore, phi is equal to 2 pi r by t. So this value, substituting in equation 2, equation 1, what we are getting from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, 2 pi r by t whole square is equal to g m by r, and that implies here you see 4 pi square r square divided by t square is equal to g m by r. Now this r you transfer here, so this is 4 pi square r square into r, this is r cube, and divided by this g m is equal to this t square. One step I am jumping this gm also this side. Now you see this 4 pi square and this gm is constant, and therefore t square equal to constant into r cube, and therefore you have t square is directly proportional to r cube. Understand? Or even you can write t square by r cube is equal to constant. Anything you can write. Is that clear? Now any other doubt? Yes, please ask if you have any doubt. Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And here R is average distance. Again, I am telling R is average distance between sun and planet. R is average distance between sun and planet. Somewhere you can write at the corner. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This problem you can solve.
Yes, sir.
So let's stop here for today. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Send me the
solution. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.